Hello viewers, I am Renuka and in today's lecture we will continue with the selection factors affecting the selection of electric motors for electric drive. We will continue with the speed control characteristics. Now we know that for DC motor the speed equation is speed is directly proportional to EB, that is V minus IaRa upon flux generated phi. While selecting a motor for particular drive, special care has to be taken for its speed variation. Now if we consider the entire range of loads, out of which some loads may require constant speed and some may require smooth speed variation, or some others may require step changes in speed. To study speed control of DC motors, as per the equation we can see speed can be controlled by three possible ways, that is by varying the field flux, applied voltage and by varying the resistor in the armature circuit. Let us study by varying the field flux. The field flux is directly proportional to field current, hence by varying the field current, flux can be varied in order to obtain the variable speed. Field current can be varied by introducing variable resistance in the field circuit. For series motor, variable resistance is connected in parallel with the field winding as shown in the figure. In the field winding which is connected in series with the armature, we connect a variable resistance in parallel. Second is by varying the applied voltage. By varying the applied voltage of motor, the speed is controlled, and another method is used where we make changes by using tap changing of the field winding as shown in the figure 2. By this, the speed is controlled by changing the tappings of the field winding, and hence the flux generation and hence the field current can be varied. Therefore, speed is varied. As you can see over here in the figure, we have got this transformer with a variable connector which changes or varies the field resistance and hence the field current. Now let us study the type of loads. Based upon the influence of gravity or compression or tension, the loads can be classified as active load or passive load. Active load, that is influence where influence of gravity occurs, and passive load which where the friction effects. For active loads, examples are lifts, hoisteries, and for passive loads, examples are mills. Now, based upon the time of operation, they can be constant and continuous, or continuous and variable loads. For constant continuous loads, example is centrifugal pumps, and for variable loads, example is conveyor belts, hoisters. Now, the load can have pulsating time period. For example, reciprocating pumps, textile loads. We can also have impact loads, for example, rolling mills, shearing mills, or we can have intermittent load which have got operating intermittents like cranes. Based upon the speed of motor as shown in the following figure, we can have constant load torque. We can have speed of motor by controlling the torque, that is fluid friction, the torque which is directly proportional to the square of the speed, for example fans, or inversely proportional to the square of speed like grinding. This is the speed torque characteristics, and here ABCD defines the torque speed characteristics, where A has got constant load torque, B is linearly, that is directly proportional to the speed, C being directly proportional to the speed square, and D being the inversely proportional to the square of the speed. Load equalization. In many industrial drives such as rolling mills, planing mills, machines, hammers, reciprocating pumps, the load fluctuates over wide range. For that, it is desirable to have smooth fluctuations of load. Otherwise, during interval of peak load, it may draw heavy current from the supply, either producing large voltage drop in the system or requiring cables or wires with heavy sections. The process of smoothing out of fluctuating loads is known as load equalization. In this process, energy is stored during the interval of light loads and it is given during the interval of peak load. Thus, the power from the supply remains constant approximately. The most common method of load equalization is by the use of flywheels. During light load period, flywheel accelerates and stores the excess energy from the supply, and during peak load, the flywheels deaccelerate, thereby supplying some of its stored energy to the load in addition to the energy supplied from the supply. Thus, the load demand is reduced during peak hours. Motors used for such loads should have dropping characteristics so that the speed may fall with the increase in load and enables flywheel to give up its stored energy. For loads in which motor have to run in the same direction, it is not to be stopped and started frequently, flywheel may be mounted on the motor shaft. For us reverse drive, such as Lorelei winders, Ward-Leonard control system is generally used for reversing the speed control, so the flywheel should be mounted on the shaft of motor generator set. With this, the topic of electrical drives is concluded. I hope this remedial class on electric drive and factors affecting of the selection of electric drives is clear to you. Thank you.